Buddha saw four sights when he was a young prince. He saw an old man, a sick man, a dead man, and a holy man. And these four sights convinced him to give up his life of luxury, to leave his family, to renounce all his worldly possessions, just so he could spread the message of ahimsa in the world, so that he could achieve enlightenment and help his disciples to do so as well. The students of 1C, 1D, 2D, bringing to you Buddha.
The enlightened one spread the gospel of non-violence by saying ahimsa paramo dharma. Buddha takitta dhina dhidina dhagdita katagadikina buddha takitta dhina dhidina dhagdita katagadikina buddha takitta dhina dhidina dhagdita katagadikina buddha takitta dhina Buddha, 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 Buddha. Jagavanna valakiyaru jivana palitta. Buddha, Buddha, Buddha. Jagavanna valakiyaru jivana palitta.
The first Muslim saint poet of Karnataka, Shishunalak Sharifa. He was a philosopher and a social reformer. And he was the disciple of Guru Govinda Bhatta, which just goes to show that the Guru Shishya Parampara transcends all barriers such as race, religion, caste, and creed. Shishunalak Sharifa had a wonderful flair for using simple words to convey a deeper meaning. Here, we have a comic piece where Sharifa scolds an old woman for entering a marketplace all by herself and for being careless and clumsy and falling down and hurting herself. Here, the old lady is a metaphor for all those of us who are actually dependent on society, on our teachers, on our families, but we choose to live as islands in isolation, often careless of our personal well-being, just in the race to get somewhere, maybe to attain academic excellence, maybe to attain financial stability. But often in this rat race, we lose out on the simple things in life that matter. And Sharifa demonstrates this to us through a simple story of a lady, an old lady, who ventures out into the marketplace by herself, clumsily, nearly falling down. The students of 3C and 3D presenting to you Shishunali Sharifa's work.
ಬಂದ್ರೋಷ್ ಶರೀಫಾ ಪದ ಹೇಳ್ತಾ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ ಶರೀಫಾ ಪದ ಹೇಳು ನೀವೇ ಪದ ಹೇಳಿ ಅದನ್ನೇ ಕೂಡಿಸಿ ಹೇಳ್ತೀನಿ ಮುದುಕಿ ಬಿದ್ಲೋ ಹುಲುಗುರು ಸಂತಿ ಗದ್ಲ
ಹರೆಯ ಮೀರಿದ ಬಿಸರು ಬಿಚ್ಚು ಗಣ್ಣಿನ ಮುದುಕಿ ಅಡಿ ಮುದುಕಿ ನೀನು ಬಿದ್ದಿಯಪ್ಪೇ ಸ್ವಾತಿ ಸ್ವಾತಿ. ಏಯ್ ಯಾಕ್ ಗಪ್ ಕೂತಿರಿ?
We now come to the icing on the cake, our final dance production for this evening, Chanakya. Chanakya is a mixed media montage which is largely based on the work by popular writer Ashwin Sanghi, his book Chanakya's Chant. Why Chanakya? Today, we're here to celebrate 25 years of a wonderful education, Soundarya Educational Institute. This is an institution that prides itself on producing not just good students, but good citizens and good entrepreneurs. That is what the goal of any guru is. A guru, an energy, a possibility, a light. Just as Chanakya was to his shishya, Chandragupta. He was the first person in the country to visualize a unified India. During his lifetime, he was an advisor, a strategist, an author, a politician. His thoughts on various subjects proved to be beneficial if adopted by people even today. Some of the key teachings that Chanakya conveys: never stop learning. One should always consider oneself a student. Whether you're 60 or 6, life always has something to teach you. And this is a principle that Chanakya lived by. Confront life. Our experiences, both good and bad, are our biggest teachers. Our obstacles, our hurdles, and tests are the factors that empower us to be bigger and better. Acharya Chanakya is attributed as the pioneer of political science and economics in India. His famous treatise, the Arthashastra, is well known as a comprehensive piece on statecraft, military strategy, and economic policy. It is one of the most widely studied books in the world today. Chanakya's Niti is particularly relevant to students. The teachings are simple but valid. He talks about anger and how it blinds a person and leads even the most intelligent of us to commit harsh and heinous acts that we regret later in life. We all know how Chanakya was the great kingmaker whose protege Chandragupta went on to become one of the most famous emperors in Indian history. This is the story of his personal life and how an impoverished poor little boy called Vishnugupta went on to become the great Chanakya.
Pavitra. Inside the gates of the royal palace, a solitary figure was speaking from the top of a stone ledge. Angry and shocked by the most recent acts of the corrupt king.
Citizens of Magadha! This tyranny has continued for far too long. This imperial thug, Dhanananda, has imprisoned the only minister capable of standing up to him. Are we just going to stand here helplessly while the wise and illustrious Prime Minister Shaktar is treated in this way? It's shameful! How many more farmers have to commit suicide because Dhanananda's tax collectors steal their grain? How many more soldiers must die in battle because their armor has been compromised to make wine goblets for the king's pleasure? How much longer will the city lie ignored while the palace flourishes? How much longer will we survive this evil reign? Insolent fool! I want Janak's head chopped off and displayed along the banks of the Ganges. How dare he defy me? Find him for me now! Go!
Took the small bundle the priest offered him. It was a parting gift, left for him by Kathyayan. It contained a small dagger for his protection, 50 gold pannas for his sustenance, and a letter to the Dean of Takshila University, located over 900 miles away in the northwest. Takshila was the world's first university. Since its establishment, over 10,000 students had graduated in over 60 subjects. Takshila was nestled in the valley kingdom of Gandhar, surrounded by hills, orchards, and wild flowers. "Whom do you wish to meet, boy?" asked the Dwar Pandit. Chanakya said he wanted to see Acharya Pundarikaksha, the dean of the university. Unfortunately, Takshila was reserved for the royal, and Chanakya was afraid he would be refused a seat. Nervously, he sat down across the Acharya as questions were thrown at him.
Of a good government, Chanakya?
In the happiness of his subjects lies the king's happiness, and in their welfare, his own welfare.
Son, what are the duties of a king?
A ruler has three duties. Raksha, protecting the state from external aggression. Palana, maintenance of law and order. And finally, Yogakshima, welfare of the people.
Oh, son of Chanak, what are the possible means by which a king can settle political disputes?
There are four possible ways, sir. Sama, gentle persuasion and praise. Dhana, monetary incentives. Danda, punishment or war. And Bheda, intelligence and manipulation.
What is the relationship between a kingdom, a country, and its people?
There cannot be a country without people, and there is no kingdom without a country.
On what basis should one test a man?
Like gold is tested by rubbing, cutting, heating, and beating, so also man is tested by his sacrifice, moral conduct, innate qualities, and his actions.
What is the root of wealth?
Acharya, the root of wealth is economic activity, and the lack of it brings material distress. In the manner that elephants are needed to catch elephants, one needs wealth to capture more wealth.
How should a king decide which kings are his friends and which are his enemies?
A ruler with neighboring territory is a rival, and the ruler next to the neighbor is to be deemed a friend. My enemy's enemy is my friend.
Astounding. Not noble, nor the son of royalty, and yet a mind as sharp as the edge of a sword, a rhetoric beyond his years and an uncanny confidence. I am impressed and curious, and I must nurture him. All right, Chanakya, son of Chanak, welcome to Takshila.
Princes and sons of nobility, aristocratic and handsome, filled the university. Chanakya's manner, raw intellect, and bold opinions on almost every subject did little to win him friends. One day, when he was walking from his dormitory to his classes,
destroy the enemies of the country, and look, he cannot even suppress the grass that attacks his foot. The great Chanakya defeated by foliage.
If you can't defeat the enemy, give him milk so that he can become even stronger and decimate you effortlessly.
No, you don't understand. This is Kush grass, revered by our Vedas. Chanakya is making the offerings to the grass so that he may please the gods. And they may do the dirty work of annihilating the adversary. Hey, Chanakya, what was in that milk you sprayed here?
The Kush was too abundant and vast for me to destroy. So I thought, if my enemy's enemy is my friend, what is the Kush's biggest foe? Fungus and ants? Both of which attack the grass and feed on it. What I poured was not milk. It was sweetened whey, my friends. The whey allowed the fungus to grow, and the sugar satiated the ants.
Why the second pitcher?
A debt should be paid off till the last panna, and an enemy destroyed till the very last trace.
Chanakya not only excelled at every subject in his curriculum at Takshila, but was also on the merit list each year. His academic prowess had earned him the position of Upacharya, and slowly Chanakya's fame and reputation as a teacher grew. Students vied with one another to be in his class. Once in a while, Chanakya would break away from the learning by rote and allow his students to ask him rapidly.